seeing about our technology here at WESH 2 is with all of our cameras, mm-hmm. we can track the storms as they're making their way through, and we're doing that right now.
Right through rush hour. In mm-hmm. fact, mm-hmm. let me show you one little particular spot there in Volusia County. You get I-4, Orange Camp Road right there. Fast-moving showers today. That has been the theme throughout the late morning and on into the afternoon hours now. And here's a brand new line right over I-4. And this puppy's humming now off towards the east-southeast at 15 to 20 miles an hour. That's fast by summertime flow standards. You can see right over towards Osteen, Kalamazoo, and Cow Creek going to be in your way right around 545, 47. Let's flip it on over now. I can go to the 3D mode here on Viper. Spin this puppy around. You can see one area of lightning right there. A second line moved offshore of Brevard County, and they had a spectacular lightning show there not too long ago. You're watching Jason at 4. He was showing you that. But here's that next wave that we're going to monitor up towards Sanford. A few lighter showers and thunderstorms just west of Melbourne, getting a bit friskier late this afternoon. Some heavy rains up towards Deer Park. But this is the main show right now, racing off towards the east-southeast at about 15 to 20 miles an hour. Some lighter showers north and west of Ormond Beach, but as we take a look at the satellite and radar trends north of here, it's actually beginning to dry on out. So I think the worst is over for Salt Springs on into Marion County. Rainfall totals today, very, very impressive. O'Galley, nearly 2 inches of rain. LBJ Middle School, 1.75 inches. And Melbourne Beach, 1.25 inches of rain. And over towards Melbourne itself proper, 1.37 inches of rain. Why is that important? That's a record rainfall for the day, eclipsing the 1.25 in 1973. Showers and storms winding down right around sunset, 83 1080 at midnight. Overnight lows, you know the drill. Mid-August, it's not going to be that cool. Overnight lows running in the mid-70s. Offshore showers and storms winding down. 11 o'clock, we're in pretty good shape. Clear skies. By the afternoon tomorrow, here we go again, right through the interior. Afternoon showers and storms get going. Then on Wednesday, there's a bigger push more towards the south, drifting up towards the north and the east by later on in the afternoon. And not much change as we get into Thursday afternoon. Afternoon highs tomorrow, 95 Eustis, 95 Mount Dora, 95 Ocala. We head south and east now into Orlando, Winter Garden, Winter Haven, Winter Park, about 95 degrees, if you get the theme there. 94 Cocoa, New Smyrna Beach, 92 Bonnell coming in at about 94 degrees. The other story, the tropics are active. We're going to talk more about Invest 93 and our other little friend up there, Gert, moving off to the north and the east, away from Central Florida as we head into the next half hour. 78, 90, 93 in between, 95 degrees tomorrow afternoon. What about your Wednesday? 40% chance for showers and storms, high temperatures, maybe a degree cooler, running at about 94 degrees. But I tell you what, Jason and Martha, right through the weekend, temperatures holding right around 93, 94, rain chances at about 40%.